Hey YouTube, it's Alex, and today I want to go over one of these songs from the 1975 self-titled album called She Way Out. It's got some cool drum parts in it, it's got some really neat tom fills that are kind of 80s sounding and sound pretty explosive when they come in. So I read an article in Sound on Sound magazine recently that kind of went over the recording process and how they got a lot of the really cool sounding drum sounds on the album. So I'm trying to replicate that and go through how I've achieved that inside of Ableton Live and with the microphones that I have here. I've got some room microphones set up here as well. So I'm just going to go over that and see how everything works out. And first I'm going to show you the room microphones that I've got set up. So the microphone setup that I've got using for the rooms today, I've got two of the Rode NT5 small diaphragm condenser microphones. Then I've got this Shure, it's an omnidirectional podium microphone that I'm just kind of using to get a weird room sound out of it. I've actually got it pointed backwards. It's about maybe 4 feet from the wall. And because of that, it's picking up a little bit more of the reflections of the room rather than the direct sound. So I'm just kind of trying it out. This way I've got more of a direct front capture of the drum set, and then this is going to be more responsible for the reflections. But since it is an omnidirectional microphone, it'll really kind of pick up all around. So I'm going to blend these in and see kind of how they work, which one sounds best. But there are other people practicing in the rooms kind of around me, so I don't know how much of that these are going to pick up, but we'll see. All right, so this is the session for the recording that I just did. And I'm just going to loop this one part here where the toms come in. Just the little fill part in the chorus. So basically what I've got at the moment is pretty similar to most of my other sessions. Close that. Just my standard overheads and then all the direct mics. But on this one, I did add those extra rooms in addition to the Ocean Way studio rooms that I usually add on to. That was in a previous video. So with this right now, if I turn off the room microphones, those stereo set of M5s that I had set up in an XY pattern, this is kind of what it sounds like with just the main microphones, the directs and the overheads. Not too bad, but the rooms definitely add a little bit more ambience in there. So let me turn these up a bit. Just got these paired into a left and right. Raise these up a little bit. So you can hear that those are adding a bit more depth to the overall recording of it. But the main trick here is the other room mics that I've kind of used, and this is how you get the kind of trick that they used on the recording. So basically for this microphone here, if I solo it, ignore this stuff for the time being. So here's what it sounds like on its own. This is that Shure, I forget what the model is, but that like podium microphone that's in an Omni pattern. Kind of here it picks up a pretty big picture of the full kit, so that in conjunction with everything else. Sounds like that. Now what they did in the recording, and if you link the article that I have in the description of this video, it's a really cool article on just how they recorded the entire album, vocals, guitars, drums, all that kind of stuff. It's one of my favorite albums. I think it was produced really well and they have a lot of really neat sounds in it, particularly the drums. So what they did with this one was they had some room microphones set up and they had gated the room mics off of the tom, or the tom mic. So what that means is that whenever the drummer for the 1975, George Daniel, hit the rack tom, it would open up the room microphones that they had. So basically whenever you hit the tom, not only are you hitting that instrument and then you have the direct mic on top of it, but it's also basically turning on the room mic, so you get a lot more of that natural room reverb. So with that by itself, if I go ahead and just gate this, so I have it set up that whenever, I have it sidechained, meaning that whenever the tom hits on here, it kind of turns this channel back on. So this is what it sounds like if I solo the gated. So you can hear the room mic only kind of opens up when that tom mic comes through. So with the rest of the mix, you can hear it adds a little bit more of the room reverb every time that tom hits, which sounds pretty cool. Oops. So what they also did with this is they put it through a distortion unit called this Culture Vulture, which is a few thousand dollars. So I have the plugin instead. And this is kind of what it looks like. So I basically just kind of messed around with this. I think they said in the article that after it was gated, it had about a second before the room sound just basically kind of cut off abruptly. So I have the distortion set. If I ungate this, you can kind of hear what it sounds like on its own. So it's adding a lot of crunch to the room microphone and really kind of saturating certain parts that are being hit louder, like the tom, because that kind of peeks through the rest of the stuff. And I just kind of messed around with these until I got the sound I was looking for, the distortion type. This one to me sounded the best for this one. And then just kind of compensated with the drive and the bias on here. I did pull off, I think, a lot of the high end, because without it, it's really brittle sounding. So I basically kind of filtered everything off, 6 kHz and above. So with that gated, you're only hearing that tom part, but it's also super compressed and kind of distorted there as well. And it was still kind of sounding a little weird to me in the context of the mix, so I just added some EQ to it, cut off a little bit of the low and dip out here in some of the harsher frequencies. You can hear it kind of poke through. Now, this is what it sounds like with the rest of the stuff. So you can hear it sounds a real, like, kind of nasty sounding tom just coming through whenever that fills hit. So with this one, it is in a single mono omnidirectional room mic. So there's not a whole lot of real depth to it. Also, the room I'm recording, and I have this maybe like, I think 7 feet away from the drum set. So you're not getting a whole lot of that sense of space. So what I did as well is if I mute this and then go back to just the normal drum recording, again, this is what it sounds like without that gated room microphone. So I went and did my rooms trick again here with the Universal Audio, the Oceanway Studios, and basically made my own room that is a lot bigger than the one I was using. So I have these far stereo mics set up, distance of about 20 feet. Did the same thing with the gate on here, sidechain from the tom. So whenever the tom hits, it kind of opens up these room microphones. And then I've got that same distortion device on here, the Culture Vulture. Little different settings, same distortion type. I think it was just reacting a little differently because this was a bigger room sample than what I had recorded. So I just kind of fine-tuned it a little bit. So this is what it sounds like without the distortion. So you can hear it's basically just adding a little bit more depth to the toms, again, without that distortion. It is gated, so it's still only letting the tom kind of come through. However, on this one, you can actually see, if I go back over to this view, oops, that for the rooms, typically I have my own balance set where I've got a little bit of most of the direct mics going into there. But for this, I only have the two toms going into these kind of fake rooms. Reason for that being, when they did this trick in the studio, from what I've read at least, they did tom overdubs, meaning that they recorded the original drum part, you know, with the full kit first, and then probably went back in after the recording and just had the drummer kind of, you know, play these tom fills and record them separately. So whereas with the OmniRoom mic, when you're letting that through, when you hit the tom, you're also hearing, you know, some of the cymbals, the kick drum, the snare, and anything else in that quick little fill that happens. So the benefit of doing an overdub like this is that you're really only hearing the elements you're hitting or overdubbing. So with that, the rooms on here, if I take off the gate, really all you're hearing is just the toms. And really, you do hear a little bit more of the drum set, but that's just bleed from the microphone that I have on the tom. So with that, you get a little cleaner signal to work with, so you can distort it a little differently. So if we do the same trick where we gate it and then put the distortion on it, this is kind of what it sounds like on its own. Then I'll add that back in with the rest of the kit. So me personally, I actually kind of prefer this than the real room microphones I use, mainly because, not that my room microphones sound bad necessarily on their own, but it's just for this type of sound, you need a really large room to really get that heavily gated tom effect on there. And really, it's not as close as I was hoping, but it still comes, you know, pretty close the way I'm kind of doing it here. But, you know, if you had a bigger room or some other stuff, you know, you could probably get pretty spot on. But I think this at least is enough to kind of, you know, show you what's going on with this and how they got that effect. I think from the article, they said that they use this kind of sidechaining a gate microphone on the rooms and a few other tracks as well. So I may do a video in the future on a couple other of their songs. I know the song The City has some really cool just drum parts in it. And that, I think, was kind of inspired by a lot of the tricks used in this session as well. But hope that provides a little bit of just explanation on how you kind of go about getting that really explosive tom sound with kind of a gated reverb trick that's a little different because it's not strictly just a reverb here, but it is kind of, you know, gating a room microphone, which is kind of the similar thing to it. But yeah, let me know what other drum sounds you like off of songs, and I can try and kind of figure them out and see, you know, what all went involved or what all was involved in the recording process and how people get particular drum sound, because there's a lot of cool different drummers out there and a lot of recording techniques that you can really play around with all this stuff in. And it's a lot of fun to kind of figure out and just mess around with. So yeah, let me know what you think in the comments and if there's any other songs you'd like me to work on. And thanks for watching.